Ed, what's going on? I'm Ricardo, the Cynical Critic, and this is RWBY Reviews, and here we are with the final episode of the Character Shorts.
And thank God for that! I believe one should only experience you briefly, if at all. That way we don't lose too many brain cells.
After this, I'll jump into the volume itself.
But there goes my ability to play the harmonica. Damn.
But before we get to our short, let's do a little recap to see what Yang has been up to.
Last time, our poor Yang was suffering from the horror of what happened in Volume 3. Yeah, people claiming Bumblebee confirmed would give anybody PTSD. But Yang, and more importantly the writers, weren't ready to waste time building the emotional impact or slow growth of her character, cause we have to get her back into the show. So after a brief, and I mean being measured in parsecs by Bill Nye brief, period of her brooding like the dumb blonde she is, Yang is finally done practicing her white privilege, puts on her solid snake arm, and gets back into ass-kicking shape. But before she can go out to hunt down her mommy, she decides to take out some of her parental issues by beating the crap out of her dad. I guess she and Weiss are secretly best buddies. Afterwards, she manages to make her way to the Kingdom of Mistral on board the Pride of the Sea.
Bumblebee confirmed.
Shut up. Where she sets out on her motorcycle. Honeybee.
Bumblebee confirmed.
Shut up!
To find her lost birdie. And maybe her sister if it's convenient.
And considering that the last two videos had our girls experiencing some flashes to their past, let's see if the flashback phantom strikes again! Lakanan? Where is he?
He's running late. The new DC movie went on a little bit longer than he thought.
Okay, we'll just continue without him. Roll the clip!
So we begin in the dark as we hear a motor running. Oh god, no! Yang! Oh, I knew we didn't spend enough time on her depression! Now it's just a setting to transition into RWBY getting her ass tenderized by Yang.
Oh yeah, smack that butt, Yang. She's been a bad little sister.
You totally could have dodged that.
Yang! I already told you! I'm just not cut out for hand-to-hand. Why can't I just use my beautiful crescent rose?
Which is...
It's also a gun.
Good! I'm just keeping the meme alive.
Yang explains that she will be leaving for Beacon soon, so she wants to make sure that RWBY can take care of herself while she's gone. But RWBY's not so interested in learning hand-to-hand combat or getting her face caved in.
Nice one, sis. You're not always going to be able to run away from your problems, though. Enough rest. Get back out here. RWBY?
No, it's...
John Cena!
What the hell was that?
Even the Grim is confused as he shows her how to really punch. Yang continues with the retaliation, but it only proves in tiring her out and getting knocked across the country. And at that moment, RWBY decides to finally wake up from her beauty sleep, only to find that Alpha Ursa is targeting her next. However, Mommy leaps in, and after a quick little nip and toss, it's clear that
Mama Bear is pissed.
Ladies and gentlemen, you saw it yourself! Yang just killed that Grim by breaking the f*** out of its arm! Thanos would be proud.
And with the rock music finally done giving us ear bleeds, RWBY runs to check on Yang.
Yang, are you okay? I didn't know how to help without my scythe. I'm so sorry.
It's okay. I've always got your back, sis.
And with that touching moment, we return to Yang riding Bumblebee.
Oh yeah, he said it! You all heard him say it! Bumblebee confirmed! Ricardo confirms Bumblebee!
And then the video ends.
And that's the end of the character short Yang, and... yes! Finally, a good one!
And no, I'm not being biased towards my waifu. My last Best and Worst character video should have confirmed that. This short was genuinely good, and there are a variety of reasons for that. Like from the fight, to the character interactions, to their development. It was all, like a steak for a man who's afraid of mad cow disease, really well done. But, as you should know, when it comes to me, as great as something might be, if it failed at something, I've gotta point it out. I'm like your mom when it comes to your life choices, when it comes to your taste in women, and when are you gonna get a real job?
When I'm good and ready, woman! Now go and die so I can have the house!
But no, this short was good, and is a great example for why you should wait and see before giving up on a season so that it can have its final say. Sure, the black short wasn't that good, and was disappointing in nearly every way. But then you get an episode like this! Not only did it manage to, in a way, reflect its trailer, but it also stood out as its own story. Again, a great start to the season.
Wait for it.
Which is why it just breaks my little heart.
There it is.
To say again, it felt a little too short.
Now, that's not to say that it was, because each of the past shorts have been as long as the trailers themselves. The issue arises with the structures of each. Weiss's was the best. Understanding what helped was having a subtle, slow start that then gradually built to a large action set piece, all the while introducing interesting character elements, either through the interactions of the characters or from the song. However, in nearly each of these, the start and each were slow, but it failed in one way or another to obtain that atmosphere that the others were dripping with. Weiss's knew to start not only with its signature music, but was non-verbal almost through the entire video, relying on minute facial cues and background clues instead. Blake's is where it faltered greatly, as its general opening was soiled by too much dialogue and an action set piece that was too underwhelming. Where the latter could have been fixed with greater focus on speed and verticality of the chase, not much could have been done with the conversation, as it was needed to communicate what had happened to Ilya and help create that link with Blake.
A link I am very interested in seeing visually.
Yang's short is where it pretty much failed altogether. The opening's lack of visuals might have sounded cool, till you realized that it was both too short and confusing to those who weren't up to date with RWBY.
And who wouldn't be up to date? Heretics?
And then following that brief opening with an action set piece alongside dialogue was definitely a misstep. That's not to say that the battles were bad, because actually they were really fun. Both seeing a younger RWBY learning to fight, as well as our original Yang, was an interesting scene and a breath of fresh air. True, neither of them were able to stand up to the one in the trailer, but then again, I doubt we'll find anyone soon who would be able to hold a candle to what Mani was able to achieve. However, this was a good try, for it did manage to have some moments of speed and style. I think the only two things that really brought it down were the movements of Yang and the camera. And while Yang is certainly no speedster, the animators do seem to struggle getting her to move with the finesse and weight of her previous appearances. A fight needs to be like a dance in the sense that each movement and action flows well into the next, leaving no room to, in a way, admire the moment.
Cause you don't know how to have fun.
As for the camera, being digital, it would be a lot less difficult in getting the right shot, but it still would require someone with an understanding of blending pacing with choreography. The fight with RWBY needed to be a bit more like Yang versus Neo, as RWBY is speed over strength, whereas the battle with the Grimm would have been vice versa. This means that the sister scuffle should have been smooth and fast, and the Ursa urgency sharp and impactful.
However, like I said, this was a good fight that re-established the relationship between RWBY and Yang and what one means to the other.
Now, while yes, the dialogue came up a bit too early, leaving no room to develop that atmosphere, it did develop another interesting piece of history between these two. Seeing RWBY before she would find herself on the path to protagonist, it's finally clear why she was so weak. Yeah, if some of you can remember, quite a few people complained that RWBY was going from badassery to bitch in a few of her fights. At the time, it seemed it was because she was lacking her scythe and wasn't skilled in hand-to-hand combat. And now I have been proven right again! So suck it, RWBY haters!
Both the character and the show.
Cause now, though it's more or less spelled out to us by the characters, we see that yes, RWBY had been more or less worthless without Crescent Rose. Which also just goes to prove that despite how great she was sometimes, she was still just a kid and couldn't handle everything. And seeing Yang try and toughen her up not only helps affirm that, but it also dips into that motherly instinct that we've seen from her before. For those not in the know,
which is understandable, that show is kinda boring. Not unlike this one.
RWBY's mother died, and Yang's ran off to be a biker mom, which left their father depressed and cut off for some time. So Yang was more or less left to raise RWBY alone, and in doing so, she became a sort of sister-mother hybrid, like the show was made in the South or something. Oh. But we've seen her watching over RWBY like this before. But to see it before RWBY was made to grow up puts it into a whole different light. Again, it's like a mother-daughter relationship with how Yang not only tries to ready her for when she has to leave, but also the way she panics over RWBY. It also gives their interactions in the first volume a whole new level. Seeing her still trying to make RWBY grow up while also being ecstatic that they're still together. And speaking about adding new dimensions to previously established scenes, last thing I'd like to touch on is RWBY's Rose Cyclone. I don't know if that's what it's called when she does this, but I checked and I couldn't find a name, so that's what I'm calling it. Either way, it appears that this is the first time that she's done it, judging by how she suddenly uses it in a time of crisis and is knocked out afterwards. No doubt the sudden burst of speed caught her off guard and slammed her into a tree. No wonder why she hates those wooden poles. It's just another instance of a young and inexperienced RWBY, which ties in so well to the theme of Yang's short. That being, again, the bond between sisters, which is strong with the Tai Yang kids, given the unique circumstances of how they grew up. Yang had always been there for her little Rose, but when RWBY ran off, she didn't do anything to get her back. So seeing Yang off to what may likely be Mistral or her mother is heartbreaking. For one way or another, she will find her way back to her little sister.
So, at the end of the day, while this character short really didn't live up to its trailer, it was a fine start to the volume, and an excellent reminder on why you shouldn't let one episode ruin the show for you.
And with the short focusing heavily on family dynamic, it does seem to suggest that the volume will be focusing on other family dynamics, like the sisterhood of Team RWBY, Yang and her mother, and the family of the White Fang. And focusing more on character than action is completely fine if not preferred. Action is like a fireworks display. Often it can be underwhelming,
especially if you live in the northern states,
or so over the top that it takes a few hours for the eyesight to come back to your brain. But eventually it ends, and you're left only with a vague memory and feeling of what happened. However, focusing on the story and character will affect you in a far more personal way, lingering in your mind and heart long after the tale has come to an end.
And it looks like we might have a promising Volume 5. And while there's no doubt going to be some issues down the road, and you can bet your slightly chubby cheeks that I will point them out,
as you should always do when it comes to them big booties,
I am looking forward to it all. So thank you so much for watching, you guys. If you enjoyed the video, hit the like button and don't forget to subscribe for more content. Just hit the notification bell or check back here every Tuesday. Don't forget to leave a comment and share with your friends. I'm Ricardo, the Cynical Critic. With me, no movie is sacred, no video is safe, but all deserve a chance. I'll catch you guys next time. Toodles!
Off with the Yang! Eh? Guys? Am I right?